Welcome to Azure Essentials. In the next few minutes, we'll explore the services in Azure to help you analyze your data across both structured and unstructured data. Azure can help you whether you typically work with structured tabular data or if you're looking to reason over large or complex unstructured big data coming from devices, services, and applications that require a more sophisticated level of processing and scale beyond traditional data warehousing. Azure has a comprehensive set of services to ingest, store, and analyze data of almost all types and scales, spanning table, file, streaming, and other data types. The Azure platform provides tools across the data analytics lifecycle. This allows you to ingest data into Azure using robust services for batch ingestion or real-time ingestion so that you can capture events as they're being generated from your devices and services, store structured or unstructured data globally at virtually unlimited scale, train and prepare your data in data stores to derive insights and create predictive and prescriptive models on your data using machine learning and deep learning techniques. Furthermore, you can extend these capabilities to real-time processing of streaming or log data. You can even leverage artificial intelligence or AI with machine learning and cognitive services for automated machine analysis. And finally, you can serve and publish this analyzed data to an operational or analytical store to help with visualizing as part of reports and dashboards. Your apps can also leverage this data directly and securely while meeting your performance needs. So let's walk through these services in a bit more detail. The first step in data analysis is connecting disparate data sets from multiple sources and ingesting them into Azure. Your data might originate in your data center, in cloud services, or span both. Now, for batch ingestion of your data, Azure Data Factory is the primary service that you'll want to use. This is an ingestion, orchestration, and scheduling service, and it determines what happens when certain events occur and which engines to use to analyze and optimally process your data. It allows you to create sophisticated data pipelines right from ingestion of the data through to the processing, storing, and then making it available for your end users and apps to tap into. There are other data movement capabilities on Azure too. If you've got a massive one-time upload, you may want to use the Azure Import-Export service to manage the bulk loading of large datasets into Azure Blob Storage and Azure Files by shipping drives to an Azure data center. If you have structured data, the Azure Data Migration service migrates data from your on-premises structured databases directly into Azure, maintaining the same relational structures leveraged by your current apps. Azure also has engines for ingesting real-time data streams. Now, these engines are capable of ingesting data at a very fast pace and catering to your processing needs down the line. Azure Event Hubs enables large-scale telemetry and event ingestion with durable buffering and low latency from millions of devices and events. Azure IoT Hubs are device-to-cloud telemetry data service to track and understand the state of your devices and assets. And if you've got custom operations to perform and you want to scale out your ingestion engines with custom logic, Azure also supports the open-source Apache Kafka in HDInsight as a managed high-throughput, low-latency service for real-time data. And of course, you can use the Azure CLI or command line interface to programmatically target and ingest multiple data formats into Azure. And if you're a developer, APIs can be called using the Azure Software Development Kit or SDK to bring in your data. Now, all the tools and services I just described can bring data into Azure. And as you plan for how you ingest data, you'll also plan for where and how the data will be stored in Azure. Azure Blob Storage can store massive data sets, irrespective of their structure or the lack of it, and keep it ready for analysis, including video, images, scientific data sets, and more. And as a managed service, you don't need to worry about the knobs and dials, it just takes care of itself. Now, if you've got particularly demanding analytical throughput requirements, or you have huge file sizes that need to be optimized for analysis, you want a specialized big data store. Azure Data Lake Store can serve that purpose. It lets you analyze all your data, both structured and unstructured, with a very high throughput, generally desired by analytics engines. It can store trillions of files, and a single file can be larger than 1 petabyte in size. Now, for operational and transactional data in structured or relational form, you can use Azure SQL DB. This works like SQL Server, but as an Azure service, so you don't need to worry about managing or scaling your host infrastructure. Of course, you can keep existing database apps in hosted Windows or Linux-based virtual machines. For analytical data that's been aggregated over the years, Azure SQL Data Warehouse provides an elastic, petabyte scale service which lets you dynamically scale your data, either on-premises or in Azure. Now, for NoSQL capabilities, if you're bringing in data that's schema agnostic, Azure Cosmos DB is a turnkey, globally distributed NoSQL DB service that allows you to use key value, graph, and document data together with multiple consistency levels to cater to your app requirements. Whatever the need, Azure has an optimal store for you. Interestingly, all these stores integrate seamlessly to the analytics engines as sources of data. With your data now stored in Azure, there are many analytics options for training and preparing your data, spanning from super scalable and involved approaches to data engineering through to automated machine analytics on serverless infrastructure. I'll start with some of the open source analytics capabilities. Azure Databricks is an optimized Apache Spark-based analytics cluster service, offering the best of Spark with collaborative notebooks and enterprise features. It integrates with Azure Active Directory, and we also give you the native connectors to bring in other Azure data services. Azure Databricks is your hub of Spark-based analytics, whether it's batch, streaming, or machine learning. Also, we've got HDInsight, a managed cluster service for a variety of open source big data analytics workloads. It helps you clean, curate, process, and transform your data in addition to scaling your machine learning workloads. Using HDInsight, you can create scale-out clusters for Hadoop, Spark, Hive, HBase, Storm, and Microsoft R Server without the need to monitor and administer the underlying infrastructure. For scale-out compute engines similar to traditional SQL infrastructure, Data Lake Analytics lets you develop and run large-scale parallel data transformation and processing programs in U-SQL over petabytes of data from your data lake. You can even leverage the familiarity and extensibility of U-SQL to scale your machine learning models from R or Python to work against massive amounts of data. Most importantly, it's a serverless environment, so you request and leverage compute resources on a per-query basis, and don't have to worry about maintaining large clusters, which makes scaling and parallel execution easy. Azure also has engines for processing real-time data streams. Now, to analyze data logged in real-time from devices, sensors, and more, Azure Stream Analytics offers a powerful event processing engine that, together with event hubs, allows you to ingest millions of events, then find patterns, detect anomalies, power dashboards, or automate event-driven actions in real-time with the simplicity and familiarity of a SQL-like language to process real-time streams. Azure HDInsight and Azure Databricks also allows you to leverage the streaming capabilities within the scale-out processing engines, like structured streaming with Spark. For more advanced analytics, Azure Machine Learning and Microsoft Machine Learning Server provide you the infrastructure and tools to analyze data, create high-quality data models, train and orchestrate machine learning as you build intelligent apps and services. In addition to these tools, scale-out cluster technologies like Azure Databricks also allows scalable machine learning with Spark ML and deep learning libraries. Beyond this, we've also built a number of first-level AI services called cognitive services, providing pre-built intelligent services for vision, speech, text, understanding, and interpreting. Finally, once you've been able to analyze and derive insights from this data, you'd want to serve this enriched data to your users. Within Azure, the best destination for all of this analyzed data is Azure SQL Data Warehouse, where you can now combine new insights with historical trends and drive a targeted conversation by maintaining one version of data for your organization. Azure SQL Data Warehouse not only supports seamless connectivity to the analytics tools and services, it also integrates well with business intelligence tools. For example, Azure Analysis Services and Power BI, which provide powerful options to find and share further data insights. If the analyzed data contains insights valuable to your end consumers, these can be populated into the operational stores like Azure SQL DB and Azure Cosmos DB so that web and app experiences can be augmented by those insights. You can even pipe data directly to your apps with Azure platform tools for developers, including Visual Studio, Azure Machine Learning Workbench, or custom serverless apps and services using Azure Functions. With Azure, you can ensure that data is consumed only by intended users and groups securely authenticated via Azure Active Directory, while network performance SLAs and privacy requirements are met using Azure Express Route. You can even hold the keys to your data once it's in the cloud with Azure Key Management Services. So that was an overview of the key services in Azure that comprise the data analytics lifecycle. If you're interested in data visualization and machine learning, these topics are covered in more detail in separate overviews on Azure Essentials. Of course, we're constantly adding new topics on Essentials, so please keep checking back for more, and you can continue your learning with our hands-on learning series at the link shown. Thanks for watching.